Linda Evangelista, what did you do to her? Welcome back, my special unicorns. Today we're going to be talking about what happened to Linda Evangelista. But who is Linda Evangelista? I hear a cry from the Gen Z say. Well, she was a supermodel back in the 90s, part of what was then known as the Trinity. So that's Linda Evangelista, Naomi Campbell, and Chrissy Turlington. She once famously said that she wouldn't get out of bed for less than $10,000 a day. Me too, babe, me too. Which is the equivalent of around $20,000 these days due to inflation. So what happened between 2015 and 2021? In a shocking revelation, Linda Evangelista said that in 2016, she underwent CoolSculpting procedure, although she does not state which areas of the body she had treated. Woman who makes career out of the way she looks has cosmetic procedure scandal. She released a statement on Instagram recently saying that she'd undergone Zeltiq CoolSculpting procedure, which unfortunately had increased and not decreased the number of fat cells and left her, quote, permanently deformed, even after undergoing two painful, unsuccessful corrective surgeries, end quote. She also states that she had not been made aware of any complications prior to having the procedure performed. There's an awful lot to unpack here. Let's just briefly look over what CoolSculpting is and how it works. You get one of these, which is attached to a machine. There is a cup on the end here. Now the size of that depends on which area it is that you're trying to treat. So you'll have a small cup, for example, which is for underneath the chin. You'll have different size cups for, say, if you're doing the bingo wings or if you're doing the abdomen or the flanks or the thighs. They're all different. The cup is then applied to the skin and then a vacuum is created in here, which then sucks the fat up into the cup and freezes the fat. Easy. The handpiece stays in place for a variable amount of time, depending on which area it is that you're treating. And then afterwards, you have some really agonizingly painful massage because the area has been frozen and the massage is designed to try to kill as many fat cells as possible. Here's Dr. Ewan having the treatment done. As you can see, he's thrilled. The CoolSculpting device lowers the temperature of the fat cells, and because the fat cells are more sensitive to cold than other cells in that area, it causes apoptosis, which is cell death, and then eventually the cell breaks apart, macrophages, so white blood cells, come along, they eat up the bits of the debris, and then they take them away. Simple. Interestingly, studies have shown that after you've had CoolSculpting, there is no increase in lipid blood level. So what went wrong? I'm going to say something controversial. Nothing! Nothing went wrong! This is a recognized complication of having cryolipolysis. F*** happens sometimes. There are no procedures which exist that have a 0% risk of complication. None. If you drink a glass of water, you might aspirate that into your lungs and die. I'd just like to give you some fun facts while you're here. Your lifetime odds from dying of heart disease in the States are 1 in 6. For the UK, it's 1 in 8 men and 1 in 15 women. From a hornet, wasp or bee sting, 1 in 59,507. From a dog attack, 1 in 86,781. Chance of being killed in a plane crash, about 1 in 11 million. So the chance of you getting PAH from CoolSculpting is actually not that high. So I fancy my odds. In a 2020 review of 2,114 patients, it was found that there was an incidence rate between 0.05 and 0.39% of paradoxical adipose hyperplasia, which is the condition that Linda Evangelista is stating that she has. Interestingly, this is slightly higher than the manufacturer's quoted rate of 0.025%. Incidence rates at all sites were dramatically reduced by over 75% with the use of the newer models of CoolSculpting units. So when you're looking at these papers, it's very difficult sometimes to elucidate what the true statistics are, because there have been several different iterations of the CoolSculpting device, the most recent being the CoolSculpting Elite. In addition to that, some of the papers state cryolipolysis, but it's not always CoolSculpting that they are referring to. There are many different cryolipolysis devices out there, some better than others, some are just made in some random factory somewhere and don't even have a label on them. Some are from much more reputable companies. You can't do CoolSculpting on the face. You can do it in the submental region underneath the chin, but you're not going to be having it on the face. I suspect there are other factors at play here, which I will come on to in a second. So what exactly is paradoxical adipose hyperplasia? In a 2017 study of 4 cases who had undergone a cryolipolysis treatment, you can see this voluminous painless swelling in the treated area, which typically occurs between 2 and 4 months after the cryolipolysis session. There are several risk factors for PAH. Being a man, having the procedure in the abdominal region, being Hispanic, having previous cryolipolysis, and genetic factors. According to the manufacturer, 55% of cases have occurred in men. From the literature in 2017, 71% occurred in men. It was previously thought that the use of a large handpiece could increase the risk of PAH. However, this has recently been questioned because it's been found to occur with handpieces of different sizes. What you will notice is that from all these pictures, you can see that this fat accumulation occurs just in the area of treatment sites. It's not outside the area that has been treated. It's literally located to the area where the cup is. Possibly Linda Evangelista had the submental area treated. As you can see in these pictures, this is how PAH works in this area. So initially, you see the fat has decreased, and then in the final picture it's increased, but it's kind of increased back to just how it was before, which makes the claim that CoolSculpting is responsible for the difference in these two pictures a little bit difficult to believe. No one really knows what causes PAH. It was originally thought that it was an inflammatory process. Another theory is that it's due to recruitment of stem cells following the procedure, as they are less likely to be damaged during the cryolipolysis. There is another surgeon on YouTube who has made a video stating that he feels it's due to recruitment of stem cells, Dr. Gary Motiki. I hope I'm saying that right, sorry if I'm not. I watched Dr. Motiki's video, I thought it was good, and I said I was gonna come back to this topic. I scrolled through the comments section, and there was not one comment there about how, oh, well, if CoolSculpting's so good, maybe you should have it done. Huh. Or indeed any kind of incendiary comments. They're all extremely positive. It must be very hard for her to be in this business that she's in, receiving comments about the way that she looks all the time, and be able to cope with that for so many years. I currently have a BMI of 23.6. And I'm sure there'll be some genius in the comment section asking me why I've never had CoolSculpting or why I'm so fat. So she must have it really hard. Indian Knight is a British columnist and she wrote about it in the Times recently, in which she says, "If your looks are your currency, their gradual erosion must feel like a profound loss of identity. It must be even worse if you're so wildly beautiful that it is literally your job, a job at which you are world class. I feel truly sorry for Evangelista, who has been forcibly ejected from the bubble and clearly feels lost and desperate outside it, to the point of publicly fat shaming herself." She then goes on to speculate that there is more at play here. She was married to Gerald Marie from 1987 to 1993. Marie, 71, is a former European head of Elite, the most successful modelling agency of them all in the 1980s and 1990s. At least 12 women have accused Marie of sexual abuse, sexual assault, and rape, in some cases when they were minors. Many of the offences are alleged to have taken place during his marriage to Evangelista, including at their home when she was away. Last year, she said of the accusers, "Hearing them now, and based on my own experiences, I believe that they are telling the truth." Just gonna leave that there. I'm just gonna leave that there, but also reference her recent new Instagram post. In this recent Instagram post, Linda Evangelista states that she has filed a lawsuit against Zeltiq Aesthetics who were the original manufacturers of CoolSculpting, saying that they failed to disclose the risk of PAH in investors in its SEC filings. Why is that a big deal? Well, of course, if there are possible additional liabilities from claims related to these rare side effects, it's possible that the product liability insurance may not be adequate to cover the company against the potential liability. Deltink's now owned by AbbVie, so I don't think that will be a problem. It also says that the marketing material and the CoolSculpting website did not mention the risk of PAH until after she underwent the procedure. I would have thought that she would have been consented for it though in the clinic, because, you know, we have to put everything on a consent form. It's all there for you to read. I find it difficult to believe that even in 2016, which is not that long ago, it wasn't on there. Just to reiterate, I don't believe that her current appearance is necessarily to do with the PAH. Maybe she did have PAH, but there's certainly some other stuff going on around her and societally that is probably contributing to her weight gain. Maybe she should have a hormone panel done as well. But like India Knight says, she's one of us now. And also, before you have a procedure done, you should check what the potential complications are. Yes, the clinic should tell you, but also do your own research. You can't absolve yourself of all responsibility. Some might say that the procedure was performed incorrectly. It's actually very, very difficult to perform this procedure incorrectly. There are so many safety checks that occur within the device itself. If the temperature is even slightly off, it shuts itself off. If it's not properly connected to the skin, it shuts itself off. I find it very difficult to believe that there was some kind of technical or user operator issue. So in her statement, she said that she had two procedures to try to correct the PAH. These procedures were probably liposuction, but it could be treatment with deoxycholic acid, which is a fat dissolver. So maybe she had Kybella or Belkyra or Aqualix or Celluform or Dezo or whatever you want to use into those areas. It probably wasn't that successful. Look at these pictures. You can see that the result is not too spectacular. And I kind of feel like that this is just how people look as they get older. Not everyone can age like Naomi Campbell or Chrissy Turlington have, the other members of the Trinity. Wonder why they look so good. Maybe it's diet and exercise.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gary Modicke, and I'm a board-certified Beverly Hills plastic surgeon. And today we're going to be going over a topic that's been in the news recently, and that has to do with supermodel Vanzo. Son of a.